to drop in, and just in time for a song.
Leaning down through the gates, watch the night suffocate all the life as it smothers the sun. I can tell by the moon you'll be joining me soon as a guest in my fortress of fun. And I can't wait to see you and once again free you, release from your humorous air. Someday I will replace that big frown on your face with a smile and a murderous glare. We are two of a kind, violent, unsound.
What is up, all you comic book fans? This is the Comic Book Villain coming to you with another comic book haul. This is my 163rd. Comic book haul for New Comic Book Day of March 13, 2019. I hope everybody makes it out to their local LCSs and gets what they want, finds what they're looking for. I had to stop at 3 LCSs today to get everything that I wanted. So there's one, that's the clear bag. Got 2 clear bags today because I had a big haul again. There's the 2 clear bags. And then the black bags where I always hit the second, but that's just supplies. And then my good buddy Jim from Jim Comics, I got an email and he told me to pick up another comic book, so I had to run to the other store. There's a LCS that's about, I don't know, not even a quarter of a mile from my house, but it's not a very big comic book shop, so they don't carry everything. I go over there to pick up certain things, like I knew they would have this one. This book that I went to go get, I knew they would have them there, so I went and ran over there real fast. Now, this one is like a franchise. There's two of these locations here in town. There's one right here by my house. There's another one way on the other side of town, which is their big location. So, like I said, I ended up just going to this one. Got ourselves another HEB looking receipt right there. Yes, sir. So let's go ahead and get started on this haul. Let's see what all the goodies we got. Let me get the books out. Oh man. I think I need to tell that guy to start putting them in the little blue bag, because they fit in the little blue bags. These bags, they're too big. They have way too much play, and my comics slide all over the place. And I did pick up two back issues that I thought were pretty cool. I saw them in a video, so I wanted them and I picked them up because I like this character, and I did not know about this character until I saw a video last night. Alrighty, here we go. Let's get this started because it is very big. Oh man, they already messed my shit up already. God damn it. That's why I hate when he breaks them out like this. Okay, well anyway, Catwoman number 9 came out. Look at that beautiful looking cover right there. From Art Germ. Of course, you know how the villain does it. Gets them 2 covers of Art Germ right there. Yes, sir. This one right here was strictly a cover buy. I think I got maybe one in two, maybe three issues of it. And then I stopped because it kind of sucked balls. This one was strictly cover buy. Oh wow, that's pretty good on the inside. Look at this crazy looking bitch on here. Oh my god, does she look crazy. Man, it's a nice looking cover, so I picked it up. Well, Adam pulled that one for me. And then, oh, this one's been really good too. This is up to issue number 5. This is The Empty Man. This has been a real good book too. I've been enjoying this one. Show you a little bit of the inside. Got some crazy shit going on. So that is a very good book. That is a B cover. I did not get the A cover. And here we go. Countdown by the Trickster. This is Flash. Number 66 came out today. This is the A cover. I wasn't feeling the B cover, so I didn't get it. I usually get the B cover if it's okay. And this one's been alright. I've been enjoying it. I haven't been hearing too many people talk too much about it. But this is Freeze. Issue number 4. This is pretty cool. I think it's like, to me it's like almost like 1, 2, 3 red light. When he says 1, 2, 3 red light, you gotta stop. When he counts, you run. Then when he says red light, you gotta stop. You gotta like freeze. Alrighty. Man, this was, and out of the two, of course, I do get Hawkman. Out of the two, was the B cover was the best looking one. Look at that. That's the B cover to Hawkman right there. Put these right here. Man, and then this week, or this time they didn't get, last time they had all three. I hate, they usually get all three of them, and this time they didn't. And like I said, and I know one of them is an incentive. It's usually the black and white. There's like a 1 in 7 or sometimes a 1 in 10. But they usually, like when they have them, they usually let me have all of them. Of course, the A and the B cover are cover price, and then the C cover is the black and white of the A cover, which is usually an incentive. But they all they got this week was the A cover of House of Muck. I'm going to order the B cover. Man, I should order the B cover. I ordered some stuff right now. That's what I did before I did my haul. I had to come home and order some stuff real fast before they disappear, before they order them all the way. Alrighty, okay. This one right here, this is a nice-looking cover. This is Immortal Hulk number 13. This is the second printing. Of course, when number 14 comes out, everybody's going to be grabbing that number 14 again. The first cameo of the Immortal She-Hulk, Red She-Hulk, or whatever. Let me move these out of the way, guys. So, alright, continuing with this haul. This one right here, the Justice League, the Demon No More. I really enjoyed the Demon, that little 5-issue run that they did. That was a pretty good story. So, Justice League Dark. I believe there's a first, I want to say a first appearance in here. Gotta double check. Inside art looks cool. So that is the A cover. This is the B cover. Yeah, beautiful looking B cover. Who did this cover? Who did it? Apparently nobody did it. Dang it. I forgot. But that is a nice looking cover right there. So, of course, this one right here, I'm sticking with this one. I've been enjoying this one. Oblivion Song number 13. Of course, by the great Walking Dead man himself, Kirkman. And then this is Old Man Quill number 1. The reprint of number, second print of number 1 came out today, but this LCS didn't bring it in, so I was going to get it, but they didn't bring it in. This one right here was, I read the description because I don't get this one, but I always buy when the covers are nice. This is a nice looking cover. And I think this is a beginning. This is a beginning of a story arc. So might just get the whole story arc on this one. That is Red Hood Outlaw number 32. And then this one right here, I still need there's like one or two issues that I need to buy. I think I need to buy like, I know issue 34 I didn't get. I think issue like 32 I need to get as well. But Scooby Apocalypse, I think this isn't the last one, plus an all-new Adamant. So, what you call it, this isn't the last issue. There's going to be one more. Okay. So it's an Adam Ant issue in the back. Okay. So that's the A cover, and then of course the B cover right there. Okay, gotta look for that one. Here's another one. This one right here was the best looking cover. I know they ordered heavy of this because I got two issues, and I don't know how many other people in their boxes got this issue. But this is Age of Conan Belt. Bellet part 1. Gotta see what this is about. Let's check it out. Let's look through it real quick. Interior art, I don't like the way interior art looks. It looks too, how do you say it, too childish, I guess you want to say it. I guess that's how I want to put it. Looks more like for younger kids. But that is issue number 1. Of course, I got the two issues that I always get. This a Apocalypse. This is Age of X-Men Apocalypse and Extracts. This is number one. I believe this is In-Hyuk Lee connecting cover. In-Hyuk Lee. Been enjoying these right here. These Age of X-Men. I think they're like two. Some of them are. I think some of them are two and three part series only. And then here it is. Hunted Part 1. The Amazing Spider-Man number 17. That is a cool looking cover. They did have the C cover, the incentive cover. It looked pretty cool. They had it there, but I wasn't going to pick it up. Then, of course, the B connector, the connecting cover. The B connecting cover for this one. This issue right there, number 17. Uh-oh, they're getting kind of thick right there. Let me move these real quick, guys. Alrighty. Continuing on. As Guardians of the Galaxy, this is coming in 1 month. This is issue number 7. I've been enjoying this one myself. I haven't really seen too many people on their putting this, posting this one on their video. I mean, people might be reading it, but I don't know if they're posting it on this. Why do we got a totally white page? Let's find out. Why do we got a totally white page? Alright. And it goes over. 1, 2. Species are the same. Okay. See if there's anything in here. Well, gotta read that. Gotta check that out. And of course, this is the weekly one, Avengers No Road Home. This is the A cover right here. And this has, of course, it has a piece of what was his name? Conan on the cover. Got me 2 copies of that. And then 1 copy of the B cover right there. Of the, that's a connecting cover. And of course, here's one that everybody was waiting for. The A cover. I don't know. To me, Jock has just been, I don't know. His art's just been looking like he's just been throwing it together. Like, he's like, I don't even know what the hell he's doing. But his art hasn't been looking up to par. That's in my opinion. But anyway, The Bat Who Laughs, The Grim Knight number 1. This is the Del Auto cover right here. You can never go wrong with the Del Auto cover, and especially at cover price. Oh, he picked up the gun. Oh, he shot the dude. Wow, pretty cool. Can't wait to read that one like everybody else. So, of course, that is a beautiful Del Auto. And you know I got the 2. Alrighty, here it is right there. And then this one right here, this is Buffy the Vampire Slayer number 3. I picked up the other one with the teacher or whatever he is on the cover. Cool stuff, but he kind of looks like what's his name, Perry, the one who just passed away. I know he came on Riverdale, not Buffy, but he came on. And then this right here was a beautiful, beautiful looking cover. Look at that. This is the D cover, I think, or C cover. Yeah, there's a heart behind him. That's a heart. So that was a beautiful cover right there. Yes, sir. You know how I do. Had to pick up 2 copies of that bad boy. Bad boy. And then here we go. Here we go. And then we're getting close to the other issue where Spawn himself is getting a new clown. This is Spawn Kills Everyone 2. This is issue number 4. This is the A cover. Look at that. The Violator or the clown dressed up as Thanos. Look at the picture of the clown right there. Nice. By McFarlane. That is a nice looking cover, of course. Had to get that black and white one too as well. Hell yeah. Uh-oh. Getting kind of thick. Time to move these over a little bit. Alrighty. Now these have been really nice covers right here. This is Spider-Gwen Ghost Spider. Number 6, this is the B cover, the Spider-Man Villains cover. Look at that. Man, these have been real good covers. still the best one, I think, from last, is from last week, is this one. That is a sick one. That one sold out quick. And of course, you know the villain got my two copies. I get my two copies of them hot books. So that's Spider-Gwen Ghost Spider number 6. And then I got my two copies, yes sir. And then this is Supergirl number 28. Of course, you know this is the Art Germ cover right here. Yes sir. Uh-oh. She's making out with somebody. She's stepping out. Alrighty, so that is, there you go, the Art Germ. And you know I gotta get me the two covers of that Art Germ right here. Oh my god, did y'all see that atrocious B cover for Superman? I don't know, man, but that fucking cover, I wouldn't wipe my ass with it. Holy shit. And they talk about Liefeld was, you know, I'd like this art back in the day, but holy crap. Look, even Superman, look at that. Look at him, see him right there with his hand? He's like fucking thumbs down on that son of a bitching cover. Hell yeah, he says, fuck no. Yeah, that B cover will stay on the shelf. And it did. A lot of people passed that damn thing up. They left it there. They ordered about maybe 15 to 20 covers on the shelf. And they were there. Nobody was touching them. They were looking and laughing, but that was about it. I was like, oh my goodness. But so that is the A cover for Superman number 9. And then look at this beautiful, beautiful Tony Stark's Iron Man number 9. Look at that. That is a beautiful cover by Alexander Lozano. Variant cover. Oh, that's right. And then, of course, the 25th anniversary one by Alex Ross. Yes, sir. Couldn't let that one up. Mm-mm. That's a nice looking. I forgot next week's 25th anniversary one. Forgot whose it is for next week. But, of course, picking that one up, too. Alrighty, Uncanny X-Men number 1, Winter's End. Alright, cool. Alrighty, cool. And then, of course, I ended up getting, this is the Winter's End, this is the Skulls cover. And I know this is a homage cover, so I picked it up. It's the Skulls, and it was an homage, so I picked it up. Uh-oh, here we go with the Wonder Twin powers. Activate. Okay. I'm going to keep moving my goddamn camera. So this is issue number 2. Issue number 1 wasn't all that bad, so I went ahead and got issue number 2. Look at this. He almost looks like, what's his name? God damn it, where'd it go? Look at it real quick. He looks like Alien Manhunter. So I got that and the B cover as well. Uh-oh, let me get these books. Getting kind of thick. It's getting kind of hectic there. Yes, sir. And then we got X-23 number 10. This is the A cover. I've been enjoying this X-23. Yes, sir. So that is X-23, the A cover. And then here is the Spider-Man's Villains cover. This one is by In-Hyuk Hercules. So, of course, you know I got my two covers on that one right there. Beautiful looking In-Hyuk cover. And then this is X-Force number 4. This is the A cover. Did not like that B cover, so that one was not coming home with me. So that is X-Force number 4. And then this, all those comics right there, they pull for me. I give them a list every week and they pull for me. Now, this one right here is a box order, like I pre-ordered it. Oh, no, here. I pulled this one. I forgot to put this one on the list. So I had to pull this one. I forgot about this one. This is Wonder Woman number 66. That beautiful looking B cover right there. So I picked it up. I pulled that one off the shelf myself. But this should have been in my box. Actually, should have had the B cover as well, but they didn't order any. I don't know why, since I pre-ordered it. I pre-ordered an A and a B cover. This is the Goon number one by Eric Powell. Can't wait to read this one. And like I said, I pre-ordered it. And I pre-ordered two copies of the A and two copies of the B, but they informed me last night that they didn't get... Sorry about that, guys, that they didn't get the B cover. I was kind of pissed. But what can you do? Hold on, I'm trying to find my receipts. There it is. The black bag. Like I said, I didn't have anything come in today, so I just picked up supplies. Got my lights and some more boards, because you know I go through boards. Guys. Well, all them books right there, probably half my boards will be gone from the other pack that I just bought last week, too. Let's see. Oh, okay. And then this is the other store that I went to. Thanks to Jim. He had told me. He said, if you don't have this, you need to go get it. Goddamn, I forgot the name. He told me the name, but I forgot. But there's a first appearance in here. And Spider-Man Deadpool, number 47. So, of course... Pick me up 2 issues. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Oh, I didn't show you my back issues. And I like the guy. And I got these for half price. And like I said, so I went through their back order bins. And they were there. I can't believe there was one there. I didn't think there was going to be two. So this is... I saw a video. This is Uncanny X-Men. Number 299. And the first appearance of... Because I love this as a villain. He's one of my favorite villains. It's the first appearance of Sabretooth and Mystique's baby. Their son. So that was in there. And then that right behind it was another one. So I said, you know what? Half price. I got them for $2 a piece. They had their Mark IV. Got them for $2. So I said, I'm taking both of them. So I grabbed both of them. Because like I said, Sabretooth is one of my favorite villains. Villain-wise, Sabretooth is one of my favorite villains. And then what you call it, so this is his son, his and Mystique's son. You never know if they do anything down the road with his son, just like they're going to do with all these, you know, the new Wolverine, the girl, you know, everybody's having kids or whatever. They might do something, you never know. So if they do, cool. If not, cool as well. I got them for $2. No big deal. So anyway, and let's see, that is my haul. Yep, that is my haul. That's all I have right now for... I don't think I have anything else coming in. Like I said, I'd like to wish everybody a happy Comic Book Wednesday. Like I said, this is my 163rd comic book haul for March 13th, 2019. Hopefully everybody makes it out to their LCSs and gets what they want, finds what they're looking for. You know what? You know, I didn't do a cover. Let me see. Is there a cover right there? No. Let's see. Oh, you know what? This is going to be my cover of the week right there. Cover of the week. Right there. That's going to be my cover of the week right there. The Spider-Gwen Ghost Spider. The Spider-Man Villains cover. Yes, sir. That's it. Right there. Alrighty, guys, that is my video. Remember, let me know what you think about it. Don't forget to hit that like, subscribe, whatever, so get the notification so you know when I post my videos up, any video that I make. And like I said, I don't have anything coming in, so I probably won't have another video till New Comic Book Wednesday next week. Alrighty, guys, the comic book villain out. Laters.